Here is a lady who turned this country upside down with her song and her mini skirt and her radicalism, I suppose, as she took on the PTA and the many forms of the establishment. Here is Jeannie C. Riley. Now that I have the two of you together, Tom T. wrote Harper Valley PTA, and I think most of you know that, and Jeannie C. Riley took it to immortality. Now, as I understand it, we have another chapter in this story. Is that correct, Jeannie C.?
15 years later.
And you're going to sing this song in a few minutes.
I'd love to.
is this the final...
I've been working all week to learn the lyrics to the same tune that I've been singing every show for 16 years, and I've learned them tonight.
is this the same melody?
Yes.
All right. Tom, since you are the writer, I will ask you, is this the final chapter?
I can't see Harper Valley going to Hawaii, if that's no. But the way this came down, Jeannie called me, and I know Jeannie so well. She called me one night and she said, I'm in a recording studio and I always wanted to update Harper Valley. So I went upstairs and wrote the song. How long did I call you back?
You called back in 3 hours, so that means you had to had it done and tried to reach us in that length of time.
I wrote it in about 2 or 3 hours and called Jeannie back, and then I think you recorded it that week. But this song is the first Harper Valley PTA was out of my consciousness. Now this one, I wrote what I thought, knowing Jeannie as well as I do, what she wanted to say about 1984 and the PTA. And we're in agreement, I think.
I thought it was perfect.
That's what she wanted to say.
All right. Is our heroine still a radical? Is she still fighting the establishment?
Well, I think so. Or the status quo, if not the establishment. The establishment's not in charge anymore. You've been reading the papers. We're out of business. This is the status quo.
All right. She is either to the left or right of center, then.
Yeah.
Tom.
To the right, I think. A little to the right.
Where did the original idea for Harper Valley come from?
When I was a little kid, there was a lady in my hometown who did pretty much what Jeannie did in that song. She went down and read off the PTA for their indiscretion, and I was knocked out because I didn't think anybody would ever speak up to a mayor or a butcher or baker or a candlestick maker or somebody in authority, you know. I never thought anybody would stand up and say, hey, I'm doing okay, leave me alone. And I was just knocked out. And I didn't write the song for about 20 years later or something like that. And I was impressed with that.
Jeannie, after you recorded the song, did members of the PTA take exception to it?
Some did. We got tons of mail, mostly cheering us on. But some would write in and say, why are you trying to ruin the PTA? Which, you know, it could have been any organization. It just happened to be the PTA that Tom wrote about, but it could have been the city council or any other organization. Everybody, however, wasn't displeased because the national president of the PTA at that time sent me an honorary lifetime membership to the PTA.
Well, that's nice. So you're still in. All right, what we're going to do, we're going to take a little break here. I can't wait to hear this song. It's long overdue. We'll take a break here, and then we'll return to Harper Valley.
There's more coming up live from Opryland, USA on Nashville Now. You're watching the Nashville Network.
Now then, I'm looking forward to this song. I believe this song, Tom, correct me if I'm wrong, was a hit in 1968.
That's right.
But it came out in August of 1968 and took the nation by storm. Well, after all these years, in this business, we call these answer records sometimes. If it were a movie, it would be number two, or Son of. Anyway, here's the next chapter in the exciting story of Harper Valley. Here is Return to Harper Valley with Jeannie C. Riley.
Y'all remember Harper Valley and the Harper Valley PTA? Where they are and what those folks are doing today. Now things have changed a lot, but we all seem to understand things better by and by. Now my daughter is the mother of two children at the Harper Valley High. She was selling tickets for the high school dance. I could win a brand new album by some stray cats if I'd only buy a chance. Well, I bought the tickets and the chance to win a brand new rock and roll LP. And when Friday came and I walked into the place, my dress was well below my knees. Mr. Harper took my ticket and he smiled at me as sober as a judge. Shirley Thompson, she was there with him. She shook my hand and then gave me a hug. You know, they're married now and my, they look so happy and contented side by side. And to my surprise, Bobby Taylor never took his eyes off of his wife. Mr. Baker stirred the punch, it was lemonade with nothing on the side. His secretary smiled at me and said she was so happy as his bride. Widow Jones is dead, she and a young kid, Mr. Curve on Lover's Lane. Mr. Kelly's gone, he drank until they said it took his liver and his brain. Music started up and it was louder than a thunderstorm in May. Well, I stood there and I laughed to see the way the kids all get their kicks today. Then I saw a man who gave a cigarette to some small kid too young to smoke. He was a full-grown man and he was set up in the parking lot of selling dope. Well, I walked around the place and saw the drummer sniffing patter of his nose. Then I walked out through the parking lot and saw these kids were taking off their clothes. They were drinking beer and popping pills and acting like they all were having fun. I got so mad at first I thought I'd go back to the house and get a gun. Hurt. Well, the music keeps on ringing in my ears and I can hear the drummer's beat. I can see the way things are and I can see the things the kids are thinking neat. Now tomorrow afternoon the PTA will meet and I got things to say to a brand new generation of the Harper Valley PTA. To a brand new generation of the Harper Valley PTA. Love one another.
an interesting song. That is a very interesting song. There is someone in the audience tonight who asked me if you were a born-again Christian.
Thanks to Jesus Christ, I am.
I assume because of that, Tom T. wrote the song the way he did.
It made me cry, really, to see the sensitivity that was revealed to me from him, knowing how I would want the song to be. I don't know how it would have been if he had written it himself. It would have been great if he put his name on it anywhere. But how he could get into my heart and know what I'd want to say that way, it blessed me.
That's a nice thing to say. How he could get into my heart. Well, we're going to take a little break here, and then I'm going to go out, take my life in my hands, and move out into the audience and meet some of these nice people. Let's hear it for Jeannie C. Riley. We'll be right back.
Thank you.